Hello people, with this mate of learning. Thank you very much for coming back to my YouTube channel. My name is Angga Rizky and now you'll learn how to design and code together with me. Today's video, I'm gonna unveil the techniques of good design for the mobile developer. The reason why I have to create this video was because I was using Android and iOS. And then a couple days ago, I was installing the new application from the Google Play Store and App Store, and I found that there were a lot of mobile application which has not designed it very well, and I was thinking that why it could be happen. And then I get the answer that a lot of developers are not using the principle of design to make their own application. And right now I'm gonna show you step by step to make good design for the user interface, especially in the mobile development. So the first process is like we have to make a wireframe. The reason why we have to make the wireframe because we're gonna sketching our ideas stroke of the pen or even with the paper. But you could also use the design software such as InVision, Sketch, Adobe XD, Photoshop, and so many things. After you explain your ideas through of the pen and paper, or we called it wireframe, we have to find the reference of the design. So that's why I'm always find the good reference of the design that might be similar to my app that I'm working on. So please keep in mind that if you find the reference of design, the reference has to be similar with the app that you're working on. Okay, for instance, currently we're working on for the application for the money exchanger, and then it doesn't make sense if we are looking for the reference of design for maybe movies like Netflix, HBO, or even YouTube, because those designs are different and has a different features either. So make sure that the reference of design has to be similar with the app that you're working on, okay? So after you got the reference of design, you could not follow 100% of that design for your own project. We don't want you to steal that design for your own benefit. We want you to use their design to become your inspiration, and you have to modify the origin design with your creativity. Because I believe every single people has different sense of art. So you could use the origin design as the inspiration, and you have to combine, maybe like, you know, combining the inspiration with your own creativity to make a new design. Because I understand as a developer, you could not follow their feature 100%. It's just based on your experience. Maybe you're not able to make the scan QR barcode, and then you just remove from the design. So means that in the origin design has scan QR barcode, and then suddenly you're not able to make it happen in the mobile development, then you have to remove that scan QR barcode from the origin design to your new design. I believe you got it right now. Okay, now the next one is layouting. Layouting is the process when you have to follow the wireframe that you did into the visual design. You could also to modify the layout in the visual design, means that you don't have to follow the wireframe that you did, but if you have something new in your mind when you're designing the visual design, then you have to change it immediately. So basically, the references of design and wireframes are only the inspiration of your creativity, but it doesn't mean you have to follow them 100%. In the visual design, they have colors, typography, images, animation, and even illustration, and many things that you might don't know yet. Now I'm gonna talk about the images. There's still a lot of developers are using the images which has a low resolution that make me feel so sad. If you need the high resolution images, you could download for free in the Unplus, Pixel, Pixabay, And what is that? Yeah, there's a lot of website which has profit, that kind of thing. So please don't use the low resolution picture, because as the user we couldn't see it clearly. And selecting the images has to be carefully. Don't just pick randomly because you like it, but pick it because you have the sense of art. Now I'm gonna talk about the icons design. I understand that developer is not really good at design, and how do we design the icon that might be so fancy that makes our design looks professionally. So to be honest, that if I don't have a lot of time, I'm going to take the free icons from Flat Icon, Icon X, Runs Icon, and Icon For You. And there's still a lot of website which has profit those icons. So you don't have to be worried to learn how to design icon, but rather than learn how to design icon, you have to learn how to choose the correct icon for your mobile application. So in the icon design, they have different types such as line icon, and then fill icon, gradient icon, or even isometric icon. So you have to choose one of them to become your own design style in your own mobile development. Okay, the next one is about typography. The way you are presenting the paragraph in your own mobile development has to be carefully, because user is reading your article, is reading your content in your own product. So the important things that we have to take care of it, first of all, is the negative space, and then length height, and font type, and then letter spacing. If you wanna use the good typography for your own product, I'm suggesting you to go to Google Fonts, because Google Fonts has provided a lot of free typography for our product. You might want to follow the trendy one, so you have to choose the featured of typography. So Google Fonts is trying to make designer, or even non-designer, or for programmer wants to make the great design product. So after you complete the layouting process like typography, icon, and then colors and a lot of things that displaying on your design, you might wanna learn how to explain your design to the everyone. So the process is called animation or user interaction design. I know that developer is using Windows, or maybe there's not really much people are using MacBook. So that's why I suggest you to use the Adobe XD, because Adobe XD is available in the Windows or even macOS. In the Adobe XD, we could also to make the animation for interaction design. Then you could easily to explain your idea of the way how your application working in the mobile development. Animation is really helping developer to understand about the interaction between those activities. Without animation, we could not explain our idea how this application is working properly. So that's why I suggest you to use Adobe XD, and you have to learn how do you animate your design. Okay everyone, I think that's all for now, and you might have some question, please just ask me in the video's comment. So thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope it was useful for you, and please help me growing up this YouTube channel by hitting that subscribe button and share with your friends. Okay everyone, with the spirit of learning, I'll see you next time. Bye.